In this video, we will be talking about Amazon Brand Story, the module available in Amazon listings. And if you are not using this feature of your Amazon product listing, you might be missing some sales. And today we invited Sasha Gorelik, the professional Amazon listing copywriter. Hi, Sasha. Don't laugh when I say professional.
I'm not laughing. I'm an expert. Good. Yeah.
Okay. So we are doing this almost at the Halloween time, and we will not have any
spooky music.
Yeah, we will not have any pumpkins flying, but we might have some bats. All right. So Sasha, what do you do in the Amazon space, and how do you help Amazon sellers?
So I've kind of gone from being sort of an only Amazon listings copywriter to also helping with brand messaging and brand storytelling, because I think Amazon has really evolved in that way that you really have to work much harder to differentiate yourself from other similar products in the marketplace. And the way you present yourself and the way you connect with your customers can make all the difference to making sales. So I help sellers with their A-plus content, with crafting brand messaging, their brand voice, and obviously like optimizing their listings, doing all the keyword research, and also helping sellers with website content, especially if they've started selling on Shopify and they need sort of email campaigns going out and all that kind of fun stuff. So anything related to e-commerce, basically.
Perfect. And this session is live, broadcast live. So if you're watching it right now with us, don't hesitate to write comments for Sasha. I think the comment box you will find below on the right side. And if you're listening this video later and you still have questions after that, don't forget to type your questions in the comment box. And at any time, if you like the content, don't forget to like and subscribe because we make nice videos. And now, how do we start? Let me have the first question from what I had prepared, which is kind of a warm-up question.
A-plus content and brand story modules. So, great question.
Yeah. So what's the difference between A-plus content and brand story?
So we can actually show a live thing, but before we show like a live example, when there are actually two separate sections that you can upload into like your listing. So when you go to enhance brand content or whatever it's called in the back end of Seller Central now, you'll be able to add A-plus content, and then you'll also be able to add a brand story section. And the brand story section usually appears above the A-plus content, although I have seen it coming below, like because Amazon sometimes tests out different sort of layouts, but usually it's like above the A-plus content. And what's great about it is that you can actually apply the brand story ASIN by ASIN, which means you can customize it for different products. So it doesn't always, this is really interesting, it doesn't have to be the same sort of brand story modules or the same images across all the ASINs in your brand. I'm gonna tell people some tips and tricks how they can take advantage of that actually for their listings.
Actually, you said you have a website prepared of an example to understand what is A-plus. Maybe we can show this before we go deeper into brand module.
That's a good idea. So let me just open one of the examples. Can everyone see my screen?
Yeah, we can see it.
Okay. So this is an example of a toy that I found. Apparently, it's like a best-selling puzzle. So here we've got the regular part of the listing with the variations, etc. And then if we go down, I've got the Helium 10 thing extension working. So if we scroll all the way down, it's a long way down, we have this section that says from the brand. So this is actually the brand story section. And you can see here that they've got this background image and they have two modules here. One is an about us module and one is a storefront module. Now, if you add more modules, it will have an arrow and you can usually scroll through and see sort of more, it's like, it works like a carousel. So you can see more and more content. And they've also added like a little header here about their brand. So that's the brand story. And then if we scroll down even more, we have here, it says product description, but sometimes it says from the manufacturer, sometimes it doesn't say anything, but this is actually premium A-plus content because it takes up the entire screen and they have these interactive modules. So this is actually the A-plus section. And what we saw above where it says from the brand, that's the brand story section. So I hope that sort of clears up what exactly it is.
Perfect. So, King, what advice do you have for upcoming or newly launched brands?
Okay, that's a great question. So what I see a lot of sellers doing is relying on what Amazon gives them. And I think that's a really bad idea because Amazon gives you these like set questions. It's like an acute, there's basically four modules. There's a about us module. There's a Q&A module, which is, it used to just have these like, what are they called? Like template questions. It was like, why do we love what we do? What makes us different? I can't remember the last one, but so it was like three template questions and that's what everyone was using. And I think that now people need to start being a lot more creative with the kind of content they're putting out into the brand story section. So I would say like, it doesn't matter if you're new or you're like upcoming, you can use that to promote even, so I'm gonna go back actually, I'm gonna stop a second and I'll say that there's three strategies you can use for your brand story section. So, and we're gonna look at some examples also, Augustus. One strategy is to really tell your brand story and really only focus on your brand, what makes you different, what kind of brand values you have, why customers should fall in love with you, all those kind of like juicy sort of brand details. Then there's another strategy for your brand story, which I've seen a lot of sellers taking advantage of, which is actually just using it to promote other products in their brand. And so they literally just use all those images, all those modules to just promote and put discounts even for other products in their brand. And then there's obviously like the hybrid version where you have the About Us section, like with a nice brand story and stuff like that. And then you also promote other products in your brand, or if you've got the A+ content underneath, I've even seen sellers highlighting even more features about that specific product. And it's kind of like an extension of the A+. Which is why if you apply it ace and base and you can kind of customize it, and then let's say you really want to put more details about a specific product, so that brand story section, you're going to add extra details and sort of treat it like an extension of the A+, basically. Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Alfred, please comment if it answers the question.
Yeah. And I think when we look at some examples, I think it will help Alfred a bit more.
You want to show these examples now, or you in general
sure,
say that they should?
Sure, why not? Look... Let's
yeah, let's
some
do
examples.
That. Yeah, sure.
And then people will be able to really get
to kind of connect to what you say.
Exactly. Okay, here we go.
Visual
I'm share a bunch
imprint.
Of examples now. Okay.
Okay.
Can
we'll
everyone see,
see
my screen?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. So I found these fishing gloves. They're actually one of like the best-selling fishing gloves. And if we scroll all the way down here, we see their brand story section. Now, this is really interesting to me because this is really ugly design, but apparently it's working. So they've got here, they've advertised that they have a new flag fishing suit. Here they're advertising that they have a hat on sale, they've got gloves on sale and all kinds of stuff. And this button actually links to their storefront. So I think that's a really, really good strategy to use, is to have the link to the storefront, because if somebody is interested in these products and is like, oh, that's cool, like look at these gloves, they're only 18 bucks. They're going to click through to your store and they're not going to be distracted by your other competitors, because up here you've got all these people who are competing with you, you know, for the same type of products. And then when they're here, they're going to click straight through to your store. So here they've literally just used loads of those modules, of these storefront modules with the link. So you can add like four different sort of product tiles, and then it has the link here, and you can add a header here, like they've got warm gloves, flexible and warmth. Whatever, not the best copywriting I've ever seen. And then they've got this lovely background image. So that's one example of how a brand is really just using the brand story section to promote other products and get people to their storefront. Now we'll go to a different listing. This one is a kid's teepee. Now I really like this branding. I think it's beautiful. So what they've got here is they've got the sort of like, this I would say is like brand storytelling. Like they're telling you, little things matter here in tiny land. That's obviously their tagline, which I think is really, really cute, because it makes parents feel like that they think of all the small details, that like it's a really special kind of brand. And they've got here, tiny land is designed to provide safe, high quality home furnishings to kids all over the world. So as a parent, I'm already like, okay, this sounds like a great brand. And then you've got these amazing pictures over here. These are the brand focus modules. These are not, I don't think they're clickable. Oh, actually they are. They have a link to this, to the actual image, to the actual products. That's really cool. So anyway, so these are definitely then not the brand focus image. They are the link to the storefront, but they don't have any text. They've just used photos all across. And you can keep going, and they have more and more and more of just beautiful photos of what their brand stands for, little children, like real pictures, not stock photos, no ugly designs. Like, you just get such a good feel from the brand, just from the brand story. And then you scroll down and you've got the A plus content down here. So I would say that this, where are we? This version of the brand story section is really sort of the hybrid, where they've got the about the brand, like a little small thing. You don't need too much text. And then they've got the promotion through to their different products. So hang on. I mean, those are actual, they actually have links. So they link to their different products. It just doesn't actually have a visit the store, like click, I don't know, clickable text on it for some reason, which I think is kind of bad, because if somebody doesn't really know how to use what the brand story is, if someone's shopping, they don't know to necessarily click through those images. So if it has the button like link to the store, then obviously people are going to be able to, you know, go to the store much easier. Hang on a second. I'm going to share another one, which I think is a really, really good example of how to use the brand story. Actually, you know what? I'm going to share this one first. And then hang on a second.
Sasha, can you also click the X at the bottom where it's like download to bar?
Yeah. This thing?
So we'll have more space.
Okay, good. So this brand, I found their brand story over here. And I thought this was a really, really good example of like storytelling in a very, very clear way that really, really makes customers want to buy from you. So they've got here the ultimate fire pit experience. So that's their main brand promise. That's what they're bringing you. And they've got the smokeless fire pit accessories, enhancing your outdoor experience, create smokeless memories wherever you go. And I'm like, this brand sounds awesome. I really want to buy from them. And I've seen brands doing sort of, this is why I'm saying don't rely on Amazon, because when you use the About Us section, the text is really tiny. People can't read it easily. Like, this is just an image module that they've used. And what they've done is had a graphic designer actually put their copy, put their brand story onto the image. And it's just so much clearer and easier to read. And then, as we see, they're promoting other products in their storefront. They're showing you how some of the products work. Over here, they've got a nice infographic. Here, just a nice brand focus image, which makes you sort of see what the brand is about. And then they've got the A plus content below. And then final sort of example, and then I'll answer questions, is this brand, Sports Research. So they are selling, this listing is L-theanine, I'm not sure how you say it. And what they're actually promoting in the brand story section is their omega-3 series. So that's really interesting to me, because someone's searching for L-theanine, but then they scroll down and they're actually seeing sort of a promotion for another type of product from this brand. So I don't know if it's the best strategy, but this looks really, really good. Like, the way it's laid out, the headline they've got on here, whoever's the graphic designer obviously knows exactly where to place the text, because what can happen is when you upload the background image and you add modules, the modules end up covering whatever you have in the background. So you have to be really careful with that. And then, yeah, so if you scroll through, they've got some photos of their omega-3 stuff. They've got a link to visit the store. So, and then here they have their About Us. So if somebody actually gets all the way to here, then they see the About Us section. So it's interesting, because as a strategy, it's not necessarily promoting the brand. It's definitely very heavy on promoting their other products.
All right.
Okay. So
yeah, perfect.
That's what I've basically seen, is those three strategies.
Okay, good introduction to understand where it is. And actually, when did Amazon started to promote or rolled out this feature?
I think not that long ago, maybe like a year or so ago. But also, I think mostly only in the US. I'm not sure if it's available yet in Europe or the UK, because everything sort of is like lagged behind when it comes to Europe for some reason. But the US is definitely, like, I think almost all the brands who have a brand registry have access to it now. And just the trick is creating good copy that people are actually going to read, and putting the design together nicely, which can be a bit tricky because you really have to size the images correctly. And then sometimes when you upload it, it doesn't look as good as it looked in the, you know, in the draft files. So yeah.
All right. So let's take this question. Is brand story section for brand awareness, or does it help to increase the conversion rate? So you gave few examples. So do you think like these kind of different strategies bring different results?
Right. So I think that definitely it's going to bring different results. So Brand awareness, like, so, I mean, it depends what, how you define brand awareness, meaning if you're promoting other products in your brand, that's one strategy of creating more brand awareness, that you actually have more and more products that customers can look into, visit your storefront and stuff like that. Whether it increases the conversion rate of a specific, of the specific product page they're on, I'm not 100% sure. I think it could, but like, let's say as a parent, for me, if I was on the kids' TP listing and I saw that they had their nice slogan, and I would actually feel like, okay, I trust this brand. Like, they're not just some, I don't know, random cheap seller from China or something, like wherever. So yeah, I definitely don't think it hurts to put it up there. I think it's definitely worth testing it. And again, like I said, you can do it ASIN by ASIN. So if you have, let's say, two versions of a child's TP, so put it on one and see if it increases the conversion rate. And then if it does, so add it to the other listing also.
And actually, I'm thinking, like, why Amazon introduced these brand modules if they had already A+ content option? Did they want something to test something horizontal, maybe?
Maybe. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, definitely we're seeing that now they've rolled out that a lot more sellers have access to the premium A+ content, which also really is more interactive modules, whereas the standard A+ is just very static images. Mm-hmm. So there definitely is something to making it more interactive, having people scroll through like carousel. Maybe it keeps them on the page for longer. I don't know.
And if someone is designing brand story, what do you think should be done first, to choose visuals or for brand story, or to have a copywriting done?
That's a good question. I always say start with the copywriting before design, because when you, like, you want to know, okay, what kind of message, what kind of story am I telling to my customers? What kind of vibe am I giving? What kind of emotional response am I trying to elicit from my customers when they see my brand? Do I want to motivate them? Do I want them to feel calm and, you know, that they trust us? So definitely start with the messaging, and then you can tell the design team, okay, we want the graphics to have this vibe, to have this kind of look to them. And then also I just really believe you need consistency. So you shouldn't be thinking about like the visuals, like now they should match the content you already have in your main listing images. There shouldn't be like a certain style for the main listing images and then a different style for the brand story. Like, you need to have consistent brand colors. You need to have consistent fonts. You need to have a consistent tone of voice. So like, I've worked with a bunch of sellers before on their brand stories. And what I usually do for them is sort of say, okay, you should use these modules. And then, or I'll say, just use the brand focus images and just create very short headlines to go on the image. Then they send it to their graphics team. They add different photos. Sometimes I'll suggest what kind of photos they should be using to showcase sort of what the copy was saying, and bring that to life. So yeah, I say copy first.
Perfect. And I just wanted to remind everyone, bring your questions to Sasha if you're watching live to the live chat. If you are searching later, a replay, type your questions in the section below, in the comment section below. And if you enjoy anything you receive here, don't forget to like and subscribe. And I would like to ask another question. Actually, before we go to the next question, I wanted to mention that Sasha has two courses, right? You're offering to Amazon sellers. We have links below. And
do you have is there a discount in the links below?
Discount. I think we don't have a discount.
Because I'm happy to give people discounts, especially if they want to buy both courses, because one of them is really just about Amazon listings and taking them to the next level, and the other course is about the A+ content.
So A+ listing, I'm just trying to, you said so far. So you are teaching is Amazon product listing, how to create, right, like selling listing. And the second one is A+ content. So you go in more in depth about A+ content, right?
Yeah, I have like a formula that I give people that I like to follow, which I really think is very helpful for people to have like a good flow of content in the A+, instead of just guessing, okay, we should maybe put this first or that next. Like, so there should be a logical flow.
So I wanted to show, this is the course about Amazon product listing.
Funny videos also.
Yeah. And this one is A+ content. So yeah, the both links you will find below in the description. and you're welcome to visit.
And you can always contact me for a discount.
Cool. And when you contact Sasha, don't forget to mention Orange Click as well. Let's see.
The other thing I was going to say about the course is that they all come with downloads as well. And as I add more downloads, you get like access forever. So it's very helpful.
All right. So since we talked about A plus content course, we have two questions about A plus content. So Kia L wants to know, can you please discuss premium A plus content? So maybe first explain what's the difference. Maybe some beginners don't really know.
Okay. So the difference is that basically A plus content has, I'm not sure exactly how many, maybe 12 different modules that you can use. Sort of there's a hero image module, there's banner modules, there's a standard 3-image module, standard 4-image module. I've done this a lot of times. There's a comparison chart, there's a left image module, a right image module. So those are basically, they're very static images. You can add like a photo and then text next to them or text underneath them. And that's it. They just stay still. And they also do not take up the entire width of the screen. So when someone's scrolling on desktop, you'll notice that a lot of sort of the big brands had access to premium A plus content. I think it was something from off of Vendor Central or if you paid a lot of money for it. And now Amazon basically decided that whoever has uploaded 15 A plus contents, you now get access to premium A plus content. And premium A plus content is just, I would say like regular A plus content on steroids. It's like really fun because you have just way more options what you can do to add content there. You can add scrolling carousel images. You can, I think, add video content. You can add a Q&A section with actual like drop downs. So it looks really, really, it just all looks premium as opposed to the regular A plus content, which is a bit standard. Although there are really nice regular A plus content, I think the premium one is just, it's another level of like, of immersive content for people to consume and hopefully buy more online.
And premium level is premium content is accessible to the same sellers who have A plus content?
Yeah, so you have to upload like 15 ASINs per month or something. Mm. That's basically what it is. And then they'll send you like a message. This basically happened to a client of mine. If he's listening, I don't know, he was like upset, but he was happy. We just finished doing literally 15 different A plus contents for his brand. And we spent ages on all the copy and the graphics for the regular A plus content. And then all of a sudden Amazon sends him a message like, you get access to premium A plus content. He's like, now you tell me, like now after I uploaded all my A plus content, he like went and redid all the regular A plus because it's just so much nicer. So many questions.
Yeah. What should I write in the brand description field about my brand if I don't have special story behind the product?
Yeah, good question. I think most brands on Amazon really do not have a special story. And there are lots of sellers who think they have a special story and it's not that special. So what you should actually be writing is why, you know, what's in it for the customer? Make them the hero of the story. Show how you solve whatever problem it is that the customer is having, because people are shopping online because they're looking for a solution to either a specific problem or a need that they have, or they want to increase pleasure in their life. So what is it that they're looking for and how can you fill that void? So if you do that, then customers will just instantly connect with you. You don't have to have a special backstory of how you broke your leg and then you decided to make some special orthopedic, you know, stuff for people. And now you're selling it online and now everyone's like, you know, really happy. So yeah, those stories are not that interesting anyway. So just show how you are the best solution for your customers. That's what I would say.
All right. And if seller feels that current product page is boring and dry, do you have any tips how to make product page copywriting more engaging and interesting for customers?
This is such a good question. Yeah. So obviously, like every brand needs to figure out how they're different, you know, how can they be more engaging and interesting? So for some brands, that might mean using humor. It might mean using puns or wordplay to really just show that you're fun and interesting. But that doesn't work for all brands. Not all brands have humorous copy. Like the sports research one, I don't know if anyone knows this, but they had like no bullfish instead of like no bull. Okay, I won't say the rest of it. But so that was like a play on words that they used. And some people will get it, some people won't. But more engaging and more interesting. So yeah, don't do boring, like really long descriptions. Like people don't have time to read that. They need like fast, copy, quick, concise. What else? Trying to think. Yeah, power words, you know, see if you can find synonyms to switch out some of the boring words that you're using and make them sound a lot more interesting. So switch out the word nice for like awesome, or I don't know, I can't really think off the top of my head, but there are, you can go online thesaurus, find power words to switch out some of the boring words in your copy. And obviously like the images, like if you're a brand that can afford to do actual lifestyle photos, like a real photo shoot, not just like something that feels like the stock models and I don't know, people just tend to like not trust that so much. Yeah, so those are my tips just off the cuff. It just also really depends on the brand. There are many different ways to make it more entertaining and engaging.
Perfect. Next question. Can I include customer reviews to the body text of the brand story modules?
Yeah, so that's a great question. I was wondering the same thing. I was wondering when brands are going to start using it to promote UGC content, like photos of customers with the with their products. And I think, I'm not sure if you can include reviews, because I've looked up the rules for A-plus content and they actually say that you're not allowed, although some brands do it, they get away with it somehow, but the A-plus content, they say you're not allowed to add reviews, because unless it's from like a very famous, well-known sort of celebrity who's endorsing the brand, but just general reviews, they don't really like, apparently. But then again, not everybody follows the terms and conditions like to a T. So, I'm not 100% sure if you can add reviews or not. You could try it, add it to one of the sort of brand focus images in the brand story section, and see what happens. I don't know.
All right. I see some, there is probably your happy customer, Seval.
Oh, happy Sasha. Customer. Thank you. Oh, yes. Hi, Sasha. Seval.
Sasha did excellent job with both of my listings. Love your... Alfred was asking question about advice for a newly launched brand. And this person says, thank you so much for showing us so many ASINs, answering my question. May you know there are any details you could assist about creating a perfect listing.
A perfect listing. I don't know if there's such a thing as a perfect listing. You know why? Because it's the weirdest thing. Like you go on Amazon sometimes and you see really bad listings that are selling amazingly well. And you're like, how are they doing this? Like the content looks terrible. The graphics are just really old fashioned. Like what is happening? So obviously that's not the right way to really go about it. I'm just saying like there are some listings that seem to work really well with like loads of text content on the A+. And you have experts that say, no, never add any text content on the A+ content. Only use banner image modules. Like just stick with the huge images and that's it. But like I don't think you should necessarily to listen to blanket statements. You need to test on your listing what's going to be best. So for instance, you can try creating different versions of the title, and you can use Amazon experiments to test the title, which version performs better. You can also do that with the A+ content as well. You can do an Amazon experiment and do a split test and see which one performs better. And yeah, so I mean, really what's perfect? Perfect is connecting with customers, really solving their problems, making sure you have all the good keywords that you need in your listing to rank, and making sure also that your images have good copy on them. For instance, I help a lot of sellers with like the main listing images to make sure that they have good headlines on the main images and on the A+ content obviously as well. So I hope that helps, Alfred.
Next question. Should I repeat information in brand story, which I have already added to A+ content?
I would say probably not. It depends. Don't copy and paste it directly. I don't know. It depends like how specific this is. Like, it's a good question, but it's probably best not to like repeat in the exact same way. Like, let's say you have an important feature about all your products that they're all, I don't know, vegan. So you could mention that in the brand story and then mention it again in the A+ content. I don't think that's such a big deal. Or even just like if one of the images is the same, like I don't think it's a huge deal, but like to make it look the same as the A+ below, I wouldn't like necessarily do that. Yeah.
Okay. Next question. Can you give some tips to define the ideal target audience for my product? What tools are helpful to do this?
Okay. Good question. That is a loaded question. So, okay, first of all, you should probably start by figuring out the gender or where they, I mean, not necessarily even the gender, I don't know. Like, you need to ask yourself, like, who is using my product? What problems are they having? And then go from there, because like there could be, I think people think about target audience in terms of demographics, but you should really be thinking about your target audience in terms of psychographics, like what unifies all these different people of different ages and genders, and why do they all want to buy this specific product? So, I guess you have to really think about what problem you're solving, I think, for your customer. I think that's a really good place to start. Now, tools, tons of tools. I mean, reading customer reviews and downloading them and really analyzing them is a great sort of chance to see who your customers are, what they're saying about your products. Other tools you can use probably are like some, SEO tools or even Facebook groups, you know, start asking. One time, this was years ago, I had a client selling stuff for betta fish, and I joined a group specifically for people who love betta fish. I asked them a question, would you guys use this type of product? Because I was like helping my client with some like target audience research. And then like loads of people commented that they would buy this for their betta fish. So that was really interesting. So yeah, so joining different groups of people who you think might be your target audience and then really understanding their psychological reasons for buying your product is really helpful.
All right, really detailed answers so far. Yeah. Very nice and interesting.
I'm giving away all my best tips. This is why I'm broke. I'm joking.
But yeah, if you need help from Sasha, you will find the link below. Don't forget to mention Orange Click and this video that she knows you came from here. And yes, also you will find below links to two courses Sasha created about Amazon product listing and about Amazon A+ content. Yes. Let's take another question. How much details do I need to share about myself as a founder of the company and the overall company in general?
So that really depends how involved you are with the brand. There are some sellers that are just completely anonymous, like they do not want to be mentioned or known as the owner of the company. Whereas there are some brands where that is their entire brand story is actually based on the founder. So there's a supplement brand, I think it's called Mary Ruth. I'm just going to look that up for a second, just so I'm not making that up. Mary Ruth Organics. Yeah. So Mary Ruth is like the founder behind this organic supplement brand. And so she is the face of the brand. So she's all over their packaging. She's in the A+ content. She's in their videos. Like she literally puts herself into the videos that they put on their storefront. So meaning if you're not really involved and there's not really like a backstory as to why you created the company, then I don't think anybody really cares about you as the founder, I'm sorry. But if you are really involved and it's your passion and you've discovered this amazing invention or you've invented something yourself or whatever it might be, and there really is a really strong connection and you want to be involved with the brand, then yeah, you can definitely share details about yourself.
Perfect. Do you usually add product keywords in the brand story and A+ content copywriting?
So definitely not into the brand story, because most of the text content, I don't think it's not going to be crawlable, especially if you're not adding, the only crawlable text that might be there is the about us section and the Q&A section. But otherwise, so no. And the A+ content, yeah, so I do try and stick some keywords into the A+ content. But again, people will give you different answers, whether or not it impacts their ranking or indexing, but most of the power is going to come from your title and your bullet points. And the back end keywords, but yeah, it doesn't hurt to add more keywords into the A+ content. And people even add keywords to the alt text of the images.
Yeah, great. And while Sasha is taking a sip of water, I want to remind you to like and subscribe this video if you enjoy the information you get and the value you get. The more you like, the more it helps our channel and the more we bring more lives like this, content like this, and more crazy and not crazy, nice guests like Sasha. Oh, she was hearing that.
I was hearing you. Yeah, it's okay. I'm a little crazy. It's fine.
And Sasha, what you will do during Halloween?
Nothing. I don't celebrate Halloween.
Okay, nothing. Maybe you'll go bat watching.
Maybe, yeah. I'll go and see the moon.
All right. Okay. Next question.
Fun. Oh, there's more questions. Okay.
Yeah, more questions. We have a question from Chesky. Let me switch off the music. Mm. Hi, Sasha. What is the most important thing to remember when designing a brand story from a visual perspective?
From a visual perspective.
I don't know
okay,
if
so
it's a good question for you.
I'm not a graphic designer, but I think I do have pretty good eye for what looks good and what doesn't. I would say the most important thing to remember is, from a visual perspective, make sure that it's not like too much on the eyes, because there is the background image that you can add. So if you add something that's like a landscape or people, it's gonna look pretty busy. So it depends then how you design the actual image modules that go on that section. So if they're more plain and you just have like really, let's say you have like a plain background, like a blue background and then white text on it, so that's gonna be easy for people to read. We actually saw an example before. If I could share my screen again, should I share it?
Yes, of course.
I'll share because I think it's easier to like actually talk about the design. Okay, here we go. Which one was it? No, not that one. That was terrible. This one is just really ugly to me. It just looks awful. It's like just such ugly images. I'm sorry if I'm offending this brand. They're actually selling really well. Now this brand, see, it's really good, like really beautiful. They've got this amazing, probably 3D rendered image of their supplement. They've got a nice plain background. They've got a really strong headline over here. And then each of these like image modules, like this one, is just a plain black background and white text. And again, with this one, like over here, they've got this, they've got sort of people in the background, but it's sort of like a blurred out image. They've got their really nice brand logo over here. And then they've got the red background and then the white text on it, which is really, really easy to read and really nice to read. And then they've got here, like they've kept going with the consistent sort of visuals of the red and the black. And here, this one is not so great because the infographic is very tiny. It's very hard to see it, but it's fine. And here they have a nice photo. So this one is not too busy. But if we go back to like, where was it? This one's just like, they've got this whole background image of guys with fish, preparing fish, fishing. And then they have these really busy images on it also. So it just doesn't look so great to the eyes. So yeah, I would say like keeping things simple is probably one of the best pieces of advice I can give. Yeah.
All right. We have a question. Do you add alt text to images? My little pumpkin elf said that yes, you can once you upload the your images on the brand story yes. content inside Seller Central. So yes, that's.
But
yes.
People should know that alt text is really for people who are visually, who are like visually impaired, because then Google tells them what's in the image based on the text that you really describe it. That's what it's really meant for, but people are using it for keywords.
All right, let's take one more question. Should I use all four available module designs on, or are there any modules which you say like, right. no, don't use it?
So honestly, like I've really gone off the About Us module and the Q&A module. I find it like I was shopping myself and I was like trying to force myself to read that section. I was like, I can't be bothered reading this. So I would say, unless you have something really, really interesting to share, I would just say, try and craft a short brand story or About Us section and put that onto an image focus module instead. Like, don't rely on the About Us section from Amazon and don't rely on the Q&A because it just kind of looks ugly and it's harder to read. So if you can make a nice plain background with really clear text with big fonts, it's going to be much better. A spider.
Oh my God. What do we do with that? Oh, go away. So next one. Do you have any tips? How could a seller analyze competitors on Amazon to understand if they have a strong brand or not?
So, I mean, what you could do to see if they have a strong brand is use some software like Helium 10 or I don't know, I'm sure there's different software also to see how much they're selling. You know, you want to see how much money they're actually making. So then you know whether or not they are doing well. That's first of all. And then second of all, you can research their brand, see if they have social media. Like that's what I do for a lot of clients when I'm doing sort of competitor analysis. I like to check out, okay, how strong is their social media presence? Like what kind of content are they putting out on Instagram, TikTok, YouTube, whatever it might be. You know, what are people saying about them, like in the comments of social media or reviews on Amazon? And then you can kind of get a grasp of, and then obviously look at how they're doing with sales. And then you can see, based on all of those things together, how strong their brand is.
Great. We don't have many questions left, so we'll be soon finishing. I wanted to remind those who are watching live, you still have a chance to ask another question. But let's see, we have here, how many modules in total would you recommend to upload for brainstorming?
That's a good question. Let me think. I would say between like 4 and 5 would be good. 5, even 6 is fine. Yeah, and then people can scroll through and obviously put the more important things first. And then if somebody is actually clicking and scrolling sort of through the carousel, then they will eventually get to the sort of the less important content, maybe. You could even have a call to action, like at the end, like visit our store here. I don't know.
Cool. And yeah, once again, don't subscribe and don't like if you don't like, but don't forget to like and subscribe if you like what we are doing. And if you like these flying bats, because today is soon the pumpkin day. So I see that Kiel says, thanks.
Thank you for listening. Whoever was listening live, well done.
Yeah, cool. And let me bring away those flies and bats. And once again, how do you help Amazon sellers? How can they help you to make money? How do you help Amazon sellers?
So you can contact me at theecomcopywriter.com. I'm sure the links will be below the description afterwards. You can also just type my name into LinkedIn, Sasha Gorelik, and you'll find me. Or on Facebook, although I prefer answering on LinkedIn. You can email me info@ecomcopywriter.com. And I am basically here to help brands who want to take things to the next level, who want to get stronger with their messaging and storytelling and really connecting with their customers. It's not for every brand, by the way. Like a lot of people who are selling sort of more generic products, they don't necessarily need my services. Like I always say that. But there are some brands where it's like your brand could really benefit from having some strong storytelling, active storytelling, connecting with customers and really engaging content. So.
Perfect. And you will find the link to Ecom Copywriter website. And also below you'll find the links to these two websites,
the courses, which is
course for Amazon sellers to improve their Amazon listing. And as you said, there are some funny videos here. Obviously you had fun recording. I know it's 1 minute, 18 seconds, but you were recording the whole day probably.
A couple of hours, yeah.
And this is another course about A+ content. Maybe later we need another course about a premium content and brand
story.
Yeah,
I think I'm going to have to add some extra modules because when I made this, it was before premium was available. So. Yeah.
Great. So these two links are available below. And now I think, that's it. Thank you very much, Sasha.
All right,
it was
fun.
A pleasure. Yeah.
Yeah.
And we can dance. All right. Thank you very much, Sasha. I hope everybody enjoyed
it.
If you really liked, click like and subscribe. Thank you. Yeah. Bye-bye. And now I would like to invite you to watch other video with Sasha, where she is teaching about A+ content. It's like the whole tutorial where she explains tips, examples, and how to do stuff so that you sell your product well.